Daniel Charles Safko, summa cum laude. Megan Marie Samuel. Leah Janelle Schaefer. Danielle Ann Schlager. Catherine Elizabeth Schwan.
Yeah! Catherine!
Jennifer Anna Scott. Ryan R. Sueda, in absentia. Monica Bianca Ziak. Carly Diane Terrace, cum laude. Leanne Regina Taylor, cum laude. Nicole Traynor, summa cum laude. Brittany Sheree Trammell, cum laude.
Yeah!
And of course,
Tiffany Danielle Trammell, cum laude. Woo!
The Purple Ranger.
Dewey, summa cum laude. Russell Cameron Warren, in absentia. Kristen Elizabeth Waybrick. Kristen Kathleen Winus, cum laude. Jared Winfield. Orcus, magna cum laude. Andrea Nicole Wolliver, magna cum laude. David L. Zigarelli. Stephanie Lauren Zunin.
The Alumni Executive Board, who will extend congratulations to our new graduates on behalf of Hiram alumni throughout the world. Jennifer?
Thank you, President Chairman. Hiram College alumni number more than 15,000 today. These alumni include a multitude who have served their communities, their profession, and their country in distinguished and exemplary ways. It's not just my hope, but my conviction that you will join these ranks with pride and dedication. On behalf of the Hiram College Alumni Association and fellow Hiram College graduates, congratulations, Class of 2009. We have high expectations of you and look forward to the contributions you will make in our world. Congratulations.
Plato and Socrates.
And even though their thoughts were deemed the aristocratic voice, they also had a thing for little boys. Catherine the Great, so it's been said, needed large animals to be fulfilled in bed. From historic rulers to the ancient Greeks, we're standing on the shoulders of freaks. Isn't life pretty? Ernest Hemingway once said, and then he put a bullet through his head. Salvador Dali's surreal paintings were godsend. You never know, he ate his own excrement. Then there's Da Vinci, for whom it required dressing in women's underwear to be inspired. From the great romantics to the ancient Greeks, we're standing on the shoulders of freaks. Truman Capote, needless to say, would be intoxicated 20 hours a day. From the modern authors to the ancient Greeks, we're standing on the shoulders of freaks. We're standing on the shoulders of freaks.